मॉर्निंग क्लास सिक्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर फोर, डैट इज मटेरियल्स ऑफ डेली यूज क्लोथ्स. सो आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू दिस पेज इन द प्रीवियस क्लास. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू मूव ऑन पेज नंबर 41. So students, open page number 41 in your science book and take a pencil to underline hard words. Now I'm going to read the chapter. I'm going to read this heading, History of Clothing. So in ancient times, people used to cover their bodies with bark and big leaves of trees or animal skins and furs. People used to just wrap these around various parts of the body in different ways. So in ancient times, man used the bark of trees and the bark of and skin of animals to cover different parts of body. Second paragraph, after people began to settle down in different communities, underline this word communities, which means society, and with the development of agriculture, they learned to weave twigs and grasses into mats, baskets and other utility items. Underline these words utility items, which mean necessary things. So after living in the society and after getting information about agriculture, man started weaving grass and small twigs to make mats, baskets and other necessary things. Third paragraph, they also used to twist vines, climbing plants and animal fleece. Underline this word fleece, which means wool coat of animals or hair into long strands. These long strands were then woven into fabrics. So then man started weaving clothes from animal skin and animal body hair. In India, cotton was grown near the river Ganga during Harappan period as early as 2500 BC. So what do you mean by Harappan culture or Harappa bond? Harappa and Mohenjo-daro were great cities of Indus Valley civilization. These cities are well known for their impressive, organized and regular layout. There are evidences, underline this word, evidences, which means proof, showing flax means jute, a plant that gives fibers, which were used in Egypt 7000 years ago. In ancient Egypt, cotton and flax were grown near the river Nile and were used for making clothes. So we got to know how old is the history of cotton and flax. At that time, stitching was not known to people. They simply used to drape, underline this word drape, which means hang a big piece of cloth around them. This is how saris worn by women originated in India. So at that time, people did not know about stitching, so they used to hang large pieces of cloth in their body like the women of today wear a sari on their body in India. Invention of sewing needle led to the stitching of fabric into various types of dresses such as shirts, pants, suits, blouses and skirts. Needle and threads were invented to sew clothes and give them a different designs such as shirts, pants, suits, blouses and skirts. Even today, fabrics like sari, dhoti, lungi and turban are worn as unstitched clothes. So students, that's all for today. In the next class, we will start from different types of fabrics. So, thank you, class.